Hello everyone. I would like to talk about one of my favorite songs, Somebody to Love by Queen. I really love this song because I listened to it growing up as a kid. My dad and I used to listen to Queen on the way to school, and Somebody to Love was always one of my favorite songs. The song reminds me of my dad and all the memories we made together surrounding music. I love how Queen depicts trying to find love and how it's translated into our current time period. I also love how they depict that you can do all you can to try to find love, but it may not come to you in that moment. I love the gospel-inspired harmonies and uplifting chorus that give the song a sense of hope and redemption, while Freddie Mercury's impassioned delivery adds depth and sincerity to the lyrics. The vocal arrangements featuring multi-tracked harmonies by the band are striking to me. The song showcases the vocal flexibility of the lead singer Freddie Mercury, and it's a beautifully composed song. The song is very popular around the world and is celebrated as one of Queen's best songs. The band itself, Queen, was together from 1971 to 1991. Before Queen was formed, Brian May and Roger Taylor were part of another band called Smile, and Freddie Mercury was a fan of that band and ended up joining them in 1970. Then John Deacon joined in 1971 and Queen was formed. Queen has many worldwide hits like Bohemian Rhapsody, We Will Rock You, We Are the Champions, and Somebody to Love. I would also like to focus on Freddie Mercury's life because I think he is the most influential person who was a part of Queen. Mercury was born in 1946 in Tanzania and lived in India till 1964 when he moved to England, where he studied art and graphic design before pursuing music full-time. Mercury's vocal range, songwriting talents, and theatrical performances contributed to Queen's drastic rise to fame throughout the 1970s and 1980s. He was known for his dramatic stage presence, flamboyant fashion sense, and charismatic personality, which made him an iconic figure in the music world. Despite his larger-than-life persona on stage, Mercury was a private individual offstage. He struggled with his identity and battled with his health, especially during the height of the AIDS epidemic in the 1980s. However, he embraced his sexuality, and that was one of the only things he kept open about his personal life, which was very unpopular at the time. Freddie Mercury tragically passed away on November 24th, 1991, at the age of 45, just one day after publicly confirming his battle with AIDS. His death sent shockwaves throughout the music world, but his legacy endured. Mercury's music, charisma, and influence continued to inspire artists and fans around the globe, ensuring that he will forever be remembered as one of the greatest rock performers in history. I will now play the song, which I'm sure you've heard before. Thank you. That's part of the song, and thank you for listening.